The Reset Collection is an Android front end which works straight out of the box. It costs around £5 or $5 depending where you live on the Google Store, but I would highly recommend checking this out. This is a front end, guys, remember, so it doesn't include any emulators or any ROMs. But after testing numerous front ends, I feel Reset fits perfectly for the Retroid Pocket 2. Now, don't get me wrong, it's not without its faults, which I will explain later, but let's jump straight into the review. So as you can see, when you first load it up, the UI is very slick and simple. It's very easy to navigate, but I just need to make you aware, you do need to let it do its magic for a couple of minutes so it installs all the correct components. On the main screen, we have got add a new system, settings, lock orientation, refresh collection, and display options. What we're going to do, we're going to jump straight into the settings section. Settings are simple yet effective, giving you the option to download what covers and box art you would like and setting a limit onto this as well. So if you don't want it to take too much space upon the device or you've got limited space, you can set how many it downloads, which is great. We also have custom videos in there. If you've got an active URL for the actual game when it scrapes, it will put it into there. But if you haven't and you want to add your own videos, you can add your own box art and your videos. At the bottom, we have got data settings, which we will discuss a little bit later. Now, let's go on and add a new system. So just before we start, I want to say the emulation is stacked out with all your well-known emulators on here, but not every single one. So if you've got a specific emulator like DOSBox that you use on a regular basis, then the Reset Collection may be not for you. So the scraping system is simple but yet so enjoyable, so I'm going to do a quick walkthrough of it now. So we're going to add a new system, let's choose the emulator we want to use, which is Super Nintendo Entertainment System. We click on that and then we get a pop-up screen of all the available emulation. So I'm just going to stick with RetroArch just because it makes it a lot easier. Once we've done this, then it will prompt us to find where the ROMs are. So you go into the ROM folder and pick the correct folder and then it will scan the folder. Once it's scanned the folder, it will prompt you and say, do you want to scrape all the ROMs? You can click yes or no, it's either or, it's your choice. Now, one thing I absolutely love about this is the fun fact feature. Now, this is displayed when you are scraping your ROMs and gives you some fun facts about games that you may have not known. So you're not just stood there waiting for the loading screen to load and scrape all the ROMs. A word of warning, make sure you have a good internet connection as the Retroid Pocket 2 has a tendency to drop out every now and again. And this will leave you having to re-import all your ROMs to re-scrape again. But once you've done that, as you can see now, we've got all our scraped ROMs. So as you can see now, we have scraped the Super Nintendo Entertainment System. Now it does give you various box types, as you can see, which you can choose as well. One thing which is really nice about it, you can actually choose the covers what you want to use on the box art. I'll show you a quick example of that now. What's also great about it as well, if it's got a URL active for a video for this, it will actually start the video up after a couple of seconds, which is a nice little feature in this front end. Now, in some cases, you may not get the box art scraped. It doesn't scrape every single game, I'm not gonna lie, but it does do a hell of a good job to do the majority of them. So you may just need to add some of the box art. Sometimes it will actually scrape the box art, but not display it straight away. So you just need to go into change box art and find the preference that you want and add it onto there. It'll already be in the system, but you just need to select which one you like. So one thing to remember, as this is a front end, you'll be using emulators to run this. I mainly use RetroArch just because it makes everything easier. Make sure though, if you do use RetroArch, to set the exit hotkey on RetroArch, or you won't be able to exit back into the front end. So that's just a little tip for you. You can choose various emulators and even choose different ones for each game. But as you can see here, some don't actually work and will crash RetroArch even though they're installed on the system. So what I would highly recommend is setting the same emulator for the chosen console that you want to run, which can be done in the settings just by holding down A, and then you will get a pop-up menu where you change your box art and so forth. So one thing we need to talk about is the backup system. I use Reset on my mobile as well, and it's great to see that we can take all the scraped files and just upload them onto a mobile straight away. Just bear in mind, you do need the ROMs actually installed on the second device, so it will scrape and identify these correctly, as well as the emulators. But it's nice just to see that you don't have to go back onto another device, install a Reset collection and do it all again. So it does save quite a lot of time. As I mentioned earlier, there is a couple of downfalls on this, and one of them is the emulators on the actual device. Now, you've got pretty much every single emulator you would like on this device, but if you're a fan of, let's say, DOSBox or GBA, this is where you will run into a problem. Now, the GBA on the Retroid Pocket 2 runs off a different version of RetroArch, and there needs to be a different source code to implement it into the front end, which I believe this is being worked on. And again, for DOSBox, that hasn't been added yet, but that would be some nice features to see in the future, more emulators added to the front end. Another thing that I would really like to see is a customization of themes. I do love the front end, it's so simple and simplistic, but to have your own themes and to get people to create themes, I think this would take the front end to the next level. My final thoughts are, this is a great front end if you're looking to pick something up out of the box and get going straight away with all your ROMs in one place. And for the price, I can't knock it at all. Simple, but yet very effective and very clean. It's straight down to the point. Yes, there are a couple of things that I would like to see implemented into the future, but I would highly recommend this as one of the front ends you use on the Retroid Pocket 2. Hopefully it's given you a bit more clarity now on which way you would like to go. If you are new to the Retroid Pocket 2 community, check out some of the videos down below. And guys, if you want to see me do anything different on the channel or review different products that are coming out, I'm always open to ideas, so leave them in the comments below. Thank you as always for being here. If you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing, because we do reviews, how-tos and a whole lot more. Don't forget to like this video, and as always guys, stay safe and I'll see you soon.